This is economics revision lesson provided by the Ministry of Education for grade 12 students. This is the second revision lesson of unit 5, which is about the market structures and the decision of a firm. And it is about the profit maximization of perfectly competitive firm. From the previous lesson, a perfectly competitive firm maximizes profits or minimize loss in two ways, called the total approach and the marginal approach. Under the marginal approach, a perfectly competitive firm maximizes profit or minimize loss by producing and selling an output level where MR is equal to MC and the MC is rising. This is because if a perfectly competitive firm is MR is above the MC, hence the firm is advised to expand its outputs. That means if MR is above MC, means the additional revenue is greater than the additional cost of production, hence there is additional profit. So if there is additional profit, the firm is advised to expand its output. And whenever the MC of a perfectly competitive firm is above MR, that means the additional cost is greater than the additional revenue, hence the firm is advised to reduce its output. So a perfectly competitive firm maximizes profit or minimizes its loss by producing and selling an output level where MR is equal to MC and the MC is rising. Now, using this example, let's see the way of maximizing profit or minimizing loss in a perfectly competitive market structure. Consider that a perfectly competitive firm that has total cost of Q cubed minus 2Q square minus 2Q plus 6 and the market price is given. Now, the rule of maximizing profit or minimizing loss is MR is equal to MC, but we don't have any information about the MR and the MC of a perfectly competitive firm. But if you have the TC, you can easily calculate the MC because the marginal cost of production is the derivative of the total cost of production. So from this, the derivative of Q cubed is 3Q square and the derivative of minus 2Q square is minus 4Q. And the derivative of minus 2Q is minus 2. And another information to get the MR of a perfectly competitive firm. A perfectly competitive firm's market price is given. And from the previous lesson, a perfectly competitive firm's market price is always equals to the marginal revenue and always equals to the average revenue, which is the demand curve for a perfectly competitive firm. So, if you don't have the market price, you can take this market price as the MR of a perfectly competitive firm. But this holds true only for a perfectly competitive firm. For other market structures, the MR of pure monopolist, monopolistically competitive firms and oligopolists is not always equal to the market price. But for a perfectly competitive firm, if you have the market price, you can take the market price as the MR. Now we have the MR and the MC. So we can go to the solution part. And a perfectly competitive firm maximizes profit or minimizes loss by producing and selling an output level where MR is equal to MC and the MC is rising. When we equate the MC and the MR, the marginal cost of production is 3Q square minus 4Q minus 2, which is the derivative of total cost. And the MR is 2, which is the market price. Now, let's connect like terms together. This will be 3q square minus 4q minus 2 minus 2 is equal to 0. Then 3q square minus 4q minus 4 is equal to 0. When we connect like terms together, now we arrived at a quadratic equation. So we can solve using the quadratic formula. So let's take the coefficient of the variable q square as a, which is 3. And let's take the coefficient of the variable q as b, which is minus 4, and take the constant number as c to calculate using the quadratic formula. So the quadratic formula is minus b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac over 2a. So from the information, minus the value of b is 4, plus or minus the square root of minus b squared, the value of b is 4, so 4 squared, minus 4 times 3, multiplied by minus 4 divided by 2 times 3, and this will give us 4 plus or minus the square root of 64 divided by 6. And now we arrived at two roots. The square root of 64 is 8, and this is 4 plus or minus 8 divided by 6. The first root is 4 plus 8 divided by 6, and the second root is 4 minus 8 divided by 6. Now this is 12 over 6, and the other root is minus 4 over 6. 12 over 6 is 2, and minus 4 over 6 is 0.66. Just leave the smaller value and take the larger value as the profit maximizing level of output, which is 2. That means the firm gets the maximum level of profit when it produces 2 units of a commodity. If the firm produces more than 2 units, the profit is lesser, or if the firm is in loss, the loss is higher. Again, if the firm produces below 2 units, then if the firm is with profit, the profit is lower, and if the firm is at a loss, the loss will be higher. So the firm should produce 2 units of a commodity. Now let's see the magnitude of profit. The magnitude of profit is calculated by deducting the total cost of production from the TR, and we can calculate the total revenue by multiplying price with quantity. The market price is given, which is 2, and the profit maximizing level of output, Q, is also given, which is 2. So this will give you price times Q minus the total cost information is Q cubed minus 2Q square minus 2Q plus 6, which is given. So the profit will be 2 multiplied by 2. This is the cost information, which is 2. We get the total cost 2 when we substitute the profit maximizing level of output 2. Then finally we left with 2. So the magnitude of profit at the profit maximizing level of output is 2. This to indicate that the firm will get the maximum positive economic profit, which is 2. If the firm produces above 2, the profit is lesser than 2. If the firm produces below 2 units, then the firm's profit is less than 2 birr. Now, let me give you exercise. Consider that a perfectly competitive firm has total cost, which is equal to Q cubed minus 4Q squared plus 2Q plus 6, and the market price is given, which is birr 5. Now, you are going to calculate the profit maximizing or loss minimizing level of output and the corresponding magnitude of profit or loss. I will give you 3 minutes. Okay, students, the solution for the exercise is the profit maximizing or loss minimizing level of output is 3 units, and the corresponding magnitude of profit is birr 12, which is a positive economic profit. Now, let's rise to the derivation of short-term supply curve of a perfectly competitive firm. Here, First of all, when perfectly competitive farmers market price is above the average cost of production, that means price is above AC, means for a perfectly competitive farm, the market price is always equals to the average revenue, always equals to the marginal revenue, and which is the demand curve for a perfectly competitive firm. So price is above AC means, since price is equal to AR, then price is above AC means AR is above AC. The average revenue is above average cost of production. Now let's multiply both sides by quantity. AR multiplied by quantity is greater than the AC multiplied by quantity. And then this will give you the total revenue, which is above the total cost of production. So whenever a perfectly competitive firm's market price is above the AC, the firm is enjoying with a positive economic profit. This is the price one, this is price two. So this is positive economic profit because this price or AR is above this average cost of production curve. Second, whenever a perfectly competitive firm's market price is equal to AC, at this point when the price is at P1, the price is equal to the average cost of production. That means price equals to AC means the average revenue equals to the AC, because a perfectly competitive farmers market price is always equals to the average revenue. So this AR is equal to AC means total revenue equals to the total cost of production. In this case, the firm neither generates profits nor incur loss. And the situation is called break-even, or the firm is earning normal profit or zero profit. So this is the break-even point. So whenever a perfectly competitive firm market price is equal to the average cost of production, then the firm is at its break-even or earning normal profit or zero profit. Said further, if the price is below P1, in this case, the firm is suffered from loss. This is a loss zone. Price is less than AC means the average revenue is less than the average cost of production, because a perfectly competitive firm's market price is always equal to the average revenue. Hence, this AR less than AC means total revenue is less than total cost of production. If the total revenue is less than the total cost of production, the firm is suffered from loss. So if the market price is less than AC, then the firm is suffered from a loss. Finally, if the price further declines from P1 to P0, in this case, the market price is equal to the minimum of this ABC curve. This tells us the firm is operating by covering only the variable cost of production by losing all the fixed cost of production. Further, if the price declines below P0, then the firm can minimize its loss by shutting down the business. So whenever a perfectly competitive firm's market price is equal to minimum of ABC, then the firm is at its shutdown point, or simply the shutdown point of a perfectly competitive firm is realized when the market price is equal to minimum of the average variable cost of production. Now, let me show you the derivation of short fund supply curve of a perfectly competitive firm. When the price is at P2, then the market price is above the average cost of production. In this case, the firm is enjoying with a positive economic profit. At this point, the market price is equal to the AC. The firm is at break-even or earning normal profit or zero profits. And below this point, the market price is lesser than the average cost of production. In this case, the firm is suffering from loss. And at this point, a perfectly competitive firm market price is equal to the minimum of the average variable cost of production. In this case, the firm is at its shutdown point. Now, the short run supply curve of a perfectly competitive firm is part of the MC, which is above the shutdown point. This is the short run supply curve of a perfectly competitive firm. This curve is the short run supply curve of a perfectly competitive firm, which is part of the MC, which is above the shutdown point. Now let's flash to the second market structure called pure monopoly. Pure monopoly is a market structure in which a single firm supplies a particular product and the product has no close substitutes. Now let's see the features of pure monopoly. First of all, there is single seller, that there is one producer or seller of a commodity. The products offered by pure monopoly is distinctive. Distinctive products are products with no close substitutes. In Ethiopia, Ethiopian Telecom and Ethio-Electric are a typical example for pure monopoly market structures. For example, if you don't want to use the SIM card offered by the Ethio-Telecom, you don't have any choice because the SIM card offered by Ethio-Telecom is distinctive. It has no close substitutes. The firm is price maker. The firm can increase or decrease the price of its commodity. There is considerable entry and exit barrier in pure monopoly. Those firms that want to join in such a market cannot easily join, and those firms that want to reform such a market cannot easily leave. That means there is considerable legal entry barrier and exit barriers. There is price discrimination in pure monopoly. That means a monopolist can sell the same product for different customers with different price. A monopolist may sell one product or the same product by 20 birr for one individual and by 40 birr for the other. So there is price discrimination. Now let's see the revenues of pure monopolies. This is the market price, which is 10,98765, which is a continually declining price. And this is the total revenue of pure monopolies, which is 10,18,24,28,30,30,28, which is calculated by multiplying price with quantity. The average revenue is calculated by dividing QR for Q, which is 10,987654. And the marginal revenue is calculated by dividing the change in total revenue for the change in Q. So change in TR is 10 minus 0 divided by 1 minus 0 is 10. Again, here the MR, 18 minus 10 divided by 2 minus 1 is 8. 40 minus 18, 24 minus 18 divided by 3 minus 2 is 6. And the next, which is 4, 2, 0, and minus 2. Now let's see some of the relationships between the MR and AR of pure monopolist. The average level of pure monopolist is always above the MR, or simply MR is below the AR. And the marginal level of pure monopolist can be negative, but the AR of pure monopolist is always positive. But both the AR and MR are downward sloping curves. This tells us if there is customer, then a monopolist will sell a commodity by lowering price of its product. When we see the profit maximization under pure monopoly, the profit maximizations for all market structures is the same. Under the total approach and under the marginal approach. Under the total approach, a pure monopolist maximizes profit or minimizes loss by producing and selling an output level where total revenue exceeds total cost by the greatest amount. For example, if in condition A, if the total revenue is BR 8 and the total cost of production is BR 7, in condition B, if the total revenue of the firm is BR 8 and the total cost of production is BR 6, in this case, the profit of condition A or case A is BR 1 and the profit of case B is profit of 2 BR. In this case, we get the higher level of profit because the total revenue of a firm exceeds the total cost of production by the greatest amount. Simply, the gap between TR and TC is maximum. This is total revenue of pure monopolist, and this is the total cost of production. Whenever TC is above TR, In this case, the firm is suffered from loss. At this point, a pure monopolist, this is equal to TR. That means the firm neither generates profit nor incur loss. And this is the break-even of pure monopolist or normal profit or zero profit of pure monopolist. Starting from this point to this point, the total revenue of pure monopolist is above the total cost of production. In this case, the firm is enjoying with a positive economic profit. Again, at this point, the firm's TR equals to TC. That means the firm neither generates profit nor incur loss. And the firm is at its break-even. And beyond this point, the firm's TC is above TR. In this case, the firm is suffered from loss again. Now, let me give you a revision question. Suppose a perfectly competitive firm has an average fixed cost of production of BR 200 at 8 units of output and average variable cost of production of 150 BR at 16 units of output. If the market price is BR 550 per unit, what will be the per unit profit in BR of the firm at 16 units of output? Students, this is all about the second revision lesson of Unit 5. Stay safe, stay home. Thank you.